Hey guys, and welcome to Tower Defense Suggestions. In this video, we're gonna take a look at you guys' suggestions for the tower defense game that we are building at the moment. In this episode, we're gonna take a look at all the awesome towers that you guys have been suggesting. The first tower that we have is from Aishlaw, and he says a poison tower which poisons anything in its range. We can change stage 5, he says, and it also has no name yet. I actually really like this design, he's really cute. I can see a lot of potential with him. I think poison in tower defense games is always a really, really cool effect to have. Most tower defenses is just hitting, so I always love effects like burn, poison, all that good stuff. And I really like the tower design, how it just slowly gets more and more corrupted by the poison. Next up, from Cody the Artist, he says, meet Sam, the cool ice cube, a melee unit that turns into a long range unit at level 5. His ability: on the 5th level, an ability called Surf will appear. It makes it deal times 3 damage and stuns enemies for 1.5 seconds. The catch is, it will have less range for one hit. So, that's an ID created by Yano. First of all, the tower looks really, really cool. I really like him, and you can definitely see that it's inspired on the map that we were building on stream, which is always a big, big plus. I really like how he changes from a melee to a ranged tower, because a lot of tower defense games don't do that, especially not on its final level. So that is really, really awesome. I can definitely see this guy being in the game. He looks really, really cute, and I just really like how he looks. Like, he's very cute, and it's just cool that it's an ice cube on the beach. Like, come on, like, how can you not like an ice cube on the beach? Very nice suggestion. The next suggestion is from Tamago-san. A kind of tower that slows enemies. Probably the splash damage too, if it only slows. The tower is a puddle of ink, and the size increases with each level. Slow enemies, walk on it. I am not sure what he means with slow enemies, walk on it. It's a little bit weird, but I really like the design. It's gonna be, like, if we're gonna implement this, it's gonna be very hard to transform this design in the blocky design, because it's so intricate and cool, but it's a really nice design. I really, really like it. I can see the animations being very gooey and flowy. And like I said, I love towers with effects behind them. Like, it can be really, really cool. He's probably would be like a late game tower, because that's a little bit how he looks. Like, most of the times in tower defense games, you want to have like the first few towers like very colorful and bright, and then later on you can do the more scary looking ones. But wow, he looks very, very cool, and I honestly would love to see him in game, but who knows. Next up, from 3MS, this is Slam, a brick wall that slams his face to attack enemies. He always suffers brain damage. When I saw this, I absolutely loved the design. Like, the main reason for that is that we can see a lot of gameplay potential with him. Because this would be one of those towers that would have like a really, 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 really small range. So you can only place him next to the path, or he does nothing, which is something that I always like in tower defense games, because it gives, you know, a little bit more different playstyle to one tower than another. And I don't know, I can definitely see his animation be like, whoop, smack, whoop, smack. You know, I really enjoy it. It's such a cool idea. I like having a wall as a tower. I can definitely see him being in the game. Not sure when, not sure if, but he would be pretty, pretty cool to see. The second to last tower is from Mensur. The tower name is Shalal. She's a sailor, obviously. She's ranged and blows bubbles, I guess. And she didn't shade because she became lazy. Because Mensur suggested a lot of towers, like absolutely a ton. I really like this design for one main reason in particular. In this tower defense game, I really want to work with elements. So, for example, you have a tower that's a water element and it does more damage to fire enemies, but less damage to grass enemies. So that's why I really like this design, like it's obviously a water unit. I really like the fact of him blowing bubbles. I think it can be really, really cute. The only nitpick that I have would be that from like level 2 to level 3, he doesn't change that much. So, I mean, if we really want to get this in the game, like level 2 and 3 should get a little bit of a rework to look different, because right now they kind of just look the same. I am such a fan of level 5. I really like the fact that she's sitting on a bubble and like changed her like her item to like this like pipe that she can smoke with like the bubbles. I really, really like that. I am wondering though, how do number 1, 2 and 3 send out the bubbles? I'm not too sure about that. Like, if we want to get this in, we really have to take a closer look at the tower, how it's gonna work, and probably have to redesign it a bit. But it's definitely very, very cool and very, very awesome. And last, but certainly not least, again from Cody the artist, meet Pau the Butterbatter, a ranged unit. This tower also has an ability. On his 4th and 5th form, he can slow down enemies whenever the ball hits them, like Glue Gunner from Balloon Tower Defense 6. Now, honestly, I have never played Balloon's Tower Defense, so I have no idea what a Glue Gunner is. But if I just read this right, he would just slow. So I know what slow means. So he looks really, really cute. Like, he totally fits the design. This is a tower that actually changes enough. Like, at level 1, he is small and cute with a red ball. At level 2, his ball changes. But not only his ball, he also grows taller. And he does that for every level. And that's what I completely love about it. That even though he changes a little, he also changes a lot. It changes his character a lot. And his story a lot, if that makes sense. So I definitely, definitely like that. Like, he would probably be like a really long-range unit, which I can totally see him being a long-range unit. And I love the fact that at the very end, his baseball bat changes to one of those rollers, because, like, obviously he is butter, so it makes sense that his final form has something to do with the kitchen. I really, really like him. He is super cute and super cool, and I would definitely like to see this guy in the game as well. Honestly, it's a bit hard to decide which enemies and which towers will be in the game at what point, but looking at these suggestions is always super awesome and super fun. I love how creative you guys are, and you know, you never know, maybe your suggestion ends up in the game one day. But these were all the suggestions for today. If you guys like these suggestions and like to see me continue this tower defense game, be sure to hit that like and subscribe button. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye!